Episode 1. What is the purpose of the economy? We're often told that the purpose of the economy is to make money, or to create jobs, or to provide moral discipline, or even that it has no normative purpose at all. But what if none of these assertions is true? According to the social credit analysis of Major C.H. Douglas, not to be confused with Chinese social credit, the economy has only one fundamental purpose: the delivery of the goods and services people need to survive and flourish with the least amount of human labor and resource consumption. How can we confirm that this is correct? Well, consider the following thought experiment. Let's assume, contrary to fact and for the sake of argument, that the purpose of the economy is money-making. What would happen if a nation's economy maximized its financial returns but did not provide its citizens with enough goods and services for them to live? The classical and most extreme example for this phenomenon would be an economy that had exported all of its production overseas. Businesses and workers would then have plenty of money, but they would also have nothing to spend it on. Without goods and services to consume, the members of an economic association would eventually perish from starvation, from exposure to the elements, or from other forms of societal collapse, such as a lack of healthcare. Running an economy as if its ultimate purpose were the maximization of financial benefits is self-defeating and unsustainable when taken to its logical conclusion. For this reason, it cannot be the case that the economy exists for the purpose of money-making. The same sort of reasoning can be applied with respect to employment or work. Is the purpose of the economy to create jobs, as many jobs as possible? Well, what would happen if, in an economy run, let's say under a command system where the government totally controls economic life, all sorts of jobs were created, enough to provide everyone with employment in perpetuity, but insufficient goods and services were being produced to maintain the population? Once again, we see that job creation cannot be the economy's purpose either. What then is a sufficient condition for keeping the economy going? The only objective which meets that requirement is actually delivering the goods and services which people expect. Money and jobs are secondary matters. The purpose of production is consumption. If that end is accomplished efficiently, which it should be, so that we can have time and energy to spend on other things besides mere material provisioning, then the economy will give us everything we need to survive and flourish, while calling on the least amount of human labor and consuming the least amount of resources. To treat money-making, employment, or any other incidental, legitimate or otherwise, as the economy's arch-purpose is to pervert the economic system from the get-go. And that matters because when things are perverted, they break down. This animated series was sponsored by the Clifford Hugh Douglas Institute for the Study and Promotion of Social Credit. For more information on Douglas Social Credit, please visit socred.org or socialcredit.com.au. Be sure to like this video and please subscribe to our channel.